Hope the lighting's okay. But welcome back. Today I've got chest. Let me see here. Yeah, chest, traps, a bit of rear delts, of course, and triceps to end off. I really had to think about that there for a second because traps aren't something that I train consistently because it's such a dominant muscle group on the top half of my body. But yeah, I'm gonna do some traps today. It's gonna be shoulder shrugs, of course, but enough talking. Let me get finished up stretching, doing abs, and I'll catch y'all after the first exercise. I'm starting off with the butterfly machine here. I liked it a lot last time. Often I talk about using my biceps to squeeze my chest when doing chest flies, and this does it really well. It's definitely gonna be a great warm-up or a great finisher for that. It's almost like I'm spamming a whole bunch of blood to my chest, getting it ready and warm, or if I was to finish with this exercise, it would just completely finish it off. But since this is my first exercise of the day, I'm just focusing on getting blood into my chest, getting warm, and yeah, that's pretty much it. It kind of reminds me of doing banded deficit push-ups, but without involving or having to involve my triceps, and that helps a whole lot. It helps a whole lot. Alright, up next I've got this, I don't want to call it a Hammersmith machine, but it's some sort of an incline machine bench variant, but kind of looks like a Hammersmith, but I don't want to call that, it just resembles one. But anyway, it feels really good. It's something I haven't done in a while, or this type of variant. I now have dumbbell incline bench. There's another machine incline bench out front over there, and I have this, so I have three things to choose from to have a variation during my next mesocycle. I don't think y'all are gonna ever catch me doing fly bench. That might be a lot. Things change, people change. As of right now, for me, when it comes to building my chest, incline bench is king. I don't like to use time on fly bench. For me, it's a waste of time. You can come and fight me on that opinion, but that's just how I think and feel about it. Seeing and feeling my chest bump through my shirt is, I don't know, it's one of those things that's like really satisfying for me. I'm not wearing a singlet, but I just see everything, and I love seeing that. For me, it's a big flex. All right, I'm supersetting dumbbell shoulder shrugs with dumbbell rear delt flies right now. Like I've said before, My rear delts are the lacking part between the three parts of my delts. I'm gonna keep working on it, just trying to figure out what exercises I wanna use in the mesocycle. I might just end up using all the ones that I've been using previously, just to get a bit of variation. But yeah, I'm gonna get my rear delts up, no problem, no issue. And with the shoulder shrugs, like I said in the last clip, my traps are really dominant, so that could be an issue. I'm still gonna train them, but just to maintain the size that I have. Maybe grow them a little bit, because if they grow too much, they'll be way too overpowering compared to the rest of my body, and I need for everything to be as proportionate as possible. There are a lot of people that ask how I've gotten my traps to grow as much as they have, and the answer is honestly to just spam a whole bunch of shoulder shrugs, whether you use a barbell or dumbbell, spam them every week, keep doing them. They are an exercise where you can use a lot of reps and a lot of sets. You can use high volume. That's what I like to use at least. So if you're a person that likes to do high reps and high volume, go for it, spam them every week.
I'm watching this clip back and I'm seeing there are a few things that I could do to get my rear delt flies to be better here. One could be reducing the incline. The incline is a bit too high probably. I could probably take it down one notch or two. Another thing that I'm seeing is that it looks like I'm using a bit of my traps to get it up. You see me resetting there because I feel it. So that's one thing I have to watch out for, and I think pulling down the incline will help a lot with that.
Wondering if I try to talk in front of the speaker if y'all hear me, but I'm gonna figure that out when I play this back. Like I said in the last recording, I'm not sure if y'all heard when I was talking, but I just had tricep pushdowns. Simple, gets the job done. No complaints. For me, I think the secret with tricep pushdowns, or I think the secret within doing tricep pushdowns correctly lies within your elbows. What I try to do is imagine that I'm doing leg extensions, but I'm doing them on my triceps. So when I'm getting to that bent position, I'm just trying to get as much stretch as I can so I can really hit that long head. I think that's where the secret is. Another thing I'm thinking about too is my triceps. They're okay. They're pretty big. They're formed, but I really want to get them conditioned over the next year. Get a lot more quality in the muscle instead of just having huge triceps. So that's my next goal with my triceps, but that's something that I'm gonna stretch out over a period of time. But yeah, I just wanted to hop in the gym, get a quick 1 hour workout in, and head home. It's getting pretty late. Just had to get this done. I thought I'd crank out another video. So hopped down to the gym, got in a 1 hour workout, and that's it for today. So chest, bit of traps, bit of triceps, and a bit of rear delts, all done. Like, share, subscribe the video. And I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll catch y'all in the next one.